Hi everyone, it's Lori from LoriStory.com. As you know, I have been making flip books lately, and I've had a lot of people in our Facebook group called Swap It. Come join us if you haven't already. But I've had a lot of people asking or interested in getting started in flip books, and they just don't know where to start. So there's so many different ways to make a flip book. There's no right or wrong. It's a lot like pocket letters. You kind of just do your own thing. But there is kind of a base flip book that a lot of people start with, and once you have this technique down, you can build from there and make all kinds of flip books. I've made them with a cinch, and I've made them out of a file folder, and I've made them 2 pages and 4 pages and 6 pages. Really, the possibilities are endless. But what we're going to do is just build a basic flip book. It's a good place to start for your first one. And what you need is at least 3 6x6 double-sided papers. If you don't have double-sided papers, you can use single-sided papers like this, and you're just going to glue them back to back so that they become double-sided. And you're just going to cut those to 6x6. So once you have your 3 double-sided papers, you need to decide how you want them to lay out. So you're just going to place them down on your mat side by side, and then remember, this will be the outside. So make sure you like both of those, and I do. So I am going to I'm going to start like this. The next thing you need is some washi tape. Now there are other ways to bind these, but this is the basic way. And I picked out 3 washi tapes that kind of coordinate with my paper selection. And I think I'm going to use this wider one. So what you want to do is set your pages out, and you want to leave just a little bit of a gap in here. And that just helps the book fold, and it also helps give it just a little bit of wiggle room for your embellishments. So once you have those laid out, you're just going to take your washi tape, and easy peasy, lay it down. And then I'm going to go ahead and flip it over. You can flip it over, or you can start over with a new strip. I just like to flip it. And that looks good. And now let's do the same thing over here. I'm going to leave a little bit of a gap. Cover it with washi. Flip it over. Cover the other side. And now we're just going to trim that off. And that's it. You just built your first basic book. Now, in order to have your book lie flat once the embellishments start getting put in there, you need to decide which side's going to fold in. So this will be the front of my book, or I'm going to go this way. Okay, so this page that is on the inside right here, we're going to trim off just a little bit. And all this is going to do is help it to lie flat once we get the book made. So I'm just going to put that in my trimmer. If you don't have a trimmer, you can use scissors, super simple. And I just trimmed off that little bit. And now you can see when the book is shut, it will lay totally flat. Now, depending on your washi tape and whether or not it's sticky, you may want to run adhesive under it. This one's pretty sticky, so I think I'll be fine. But it just helps reinforce it. Now, the object of a flip book, of course, is that it flips. So we have a flip here, and we have a flip here. You could create yet another page and put it up here, and it would flip this way, or down here, or here, or here, or you could even put yet another page here and have the two pages flip in and then close. So this is what I mean by this is the base book and you can build from here. A lot of people just do the three-page book and that's totally fine. And the idea behind a flipbook, it's a pen pal swap method. You're going to make a flipbook, you're going to send it to a pen pal, and they're going to make a flipbook and send you one back. And you kind of put little goodies here and there, much like a pocket letter, if you've ever done a pocket letter. You fill the inside up with maybe pockets or envelopes or anything that you can tuck little goodies into. And again, there's really no right or wrong. A lot of people like to put what is called a mail tag inside. And all that is a little tag that has a little bit about you, or maybe it has some questions you want to ask your pen pal. You include that in there. You don't have to, that's up to you. If you don't include that, probably should include some kind of letter or a little bit of a note to your pen pal. But again, there's really no right or wrong of what you include and what you don't. The other thing that people like to include in their pocket letter is an About Me card, which maybe it's your top five favorite things or just something random, five fun facts about you, or just a little note that's about me. So I'm going to go ahead and decorate this just to give you an idea, and I really don't have any plan for this, so we'll see where it takes us. But again, this is your basic flipbook for beginners, and this is a perfect place to start. It's totally acceptable. A lot of people use these well after they've made several flipbooks. So let's get started, and I'm going to decorate. Thank you. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on a basic flipbook. Don't forget to join us on our Facebook group called Swap It. I'll have a link below the video. Come back again. I'll see you soon. Bye!